All right. For some reason, I keep hitting the wrong button and stopping the recording. So here's part three of our princess. We have the dress all filled in. She has her arms and her neckline all finished up. Now we're going to do the face. We're going to learn what a raisin is. A raisin is a way to connect points. A raisin in balloon speak is when you take a scrap of 260 balloon and you tie two or three knots in it. And then I'm going to ask my son to stop over talking me. I said he could play as long as he didn't do any talking. My son is blessed with a very loud voice. Ooh, yay me! Okay, here we go. It's in. Now I'm going to inflate. Okay, this is the 5-inch blush balloon. You do not want it all the way. When I tie a knot, there's going to be just a little bit of a neck. When we catch that raisin, we need a little bit of leeway. Now, I'm doing a character of a real person. According to the photo, the lady likes to part her hair on the side. So, from my view, if I'm looking at her face, the side of her hair would be right here. So, get my fingers into position, and I shake the little balloon raisin we made into that spot, and I pinch it. And then I twist the balloon around, and it's caught like that. I then take a 260 balloon. I wrap it several times around the caught raisin. I still haven't let go of the raisin. I'm going to do an over-under knot. To catch and hold that point. I'm going to be tying it some more times, so because these are long, I used an entire 260, it will not unravel and run away from us. Now from this point, I'm going to connect the balloon to the neck. So I grab the base of the balloon, the knot's up here. So I just grab it till I have the base of the balloon here, and I'm going to twist around the pinch. I'm going to twist around one loop twist, and then I'm going to loop around the other loop twist, and then I'm going to let go, causing the head to be like this, and there's the side of her hair. Now we're going to take our next 260 yellow. I'm wondering if I needed to put a little more air in it, but we'll deal with that when we get there, right? Okay. As long as my son doesn't do any talking, everything should be fine. Okay, I've gone around the loop twist again. The head's going to move around and not look quite finished until we're all done. That's okay. The lady has bobbed hair, so I'm going to start by making just a little spacer bubble from the neck of the balloon out to the side of her head. You see that it matches? Then we go up and start following the curve of the balloon to where the caught raisin is. I twist right there, twist it several times. Now I'm going to take one of the ties for the pinch twist and wrap around. And I'm going to tie a knot. So twist the balloon going around several times will help make more strength in that one point. And then the rest of this is going to go around to right where the face curves and where it matches over here. So it's coming along like this. Then we do a spacer bubble and we go back into the neck. We take our thumb and we push the balloon into that joint and we go around the neck. And then to anchor it, we can go around one of the loop twists because we don't want to put a lot of pressure just around the neck. So we go around the loop till we're in the very back of the head. We're going to do another spacer bubble. And this time we're going to do a pinch twist. But all the rest of our hair going up and down is going to connect to this pinch twist. So you want to make sure that it's that's a little squishy. You can squish and you can feel it move up and down. So it's a soft pinch twist. And then we give it a squeeze and we come back here to the where the part of the hair is. So after we measure it, I'm just going to move these balloons around a little bit. Okay. I've made my measure. I've twisted here. I can push down. I'm going to take this and I'm going to go just underneath it, just as a way to lock twist it in place up here. And then I'm going to do a pinch twist. That'll help cover future joints. I'm going to leave this here until I'm ready to cut it off. So the back of your princess looks like this. Here's the ties for that raisin. Here's the front. Here's your second balloon. Now, if you grab the balloon and pull gently as you slide your hand down its length, my son's talking, it'll actually make your balloon longer. And now I want to end at the top of the balloon. So I need to remember if I need to start at the top or bottom. So if I start here, we're going to go down 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you want to start at the top so it ends at the top. Okay, so we've connected to the pinch twist at the top. We're going to go down and around the back spacer bubble. So this is the first bubble. This was that middle bubble. So we attached at the top and we went down this bubble. And now the next three are going to fill in this space here. We're going to go up. We're going to go down. And then up one more time. Now what I was doing is I noticed that some of the bubbles were sitting on top of each other and some of them were tucked under, and what they needed was they needed to be equal pressure, so I pulled them apart and I set them together just like you do when you do the flower petal. There's this gap here, but that's going to be fixed at this next part. This is not quite long enough. But when I take this and I pull it over and under, it's going to tie that hair back and close that gap that's right there. So some of the stall, some parts I'm ending up making bigger than the original. Sometimes it'll do that. So that just means you'll need to use more balloons. here's a chewed up balloon. How chewed up is it? Sometimes you'll get a bag of balloons from Qualitex that's chewed up, but not very often. So this balloon is 50% gone. Let's add some air to this. It still gives us just enough to work with. These other balloons that end up at the top are not long enough. So I'm going to cut them both, crisscross, and one goes under. A gentle pull, so I'll pull fast. That creates friction. Friction creates heat. Heat will pop your balloon. You know how you get red burn? Well, latex can get latex burn too. Okay. Now we're ready to finish the hair. We take the end of our balloon and we wrap around that pinch twist, and then we tuck it under and in the back like this. Now we're going to take this balloon, pull it over, go under all the layers of balloon. Basically, I've gone through 1, 2, 3, 4. I've gone under 4 layers. Give it a nice strong pull, tucking it in, pulling this back, and then down and around that back hair pinch twist. I think I might have made that back pinch twist going up a little too long, but I compensated. So there we go. She has shoulder length bobbed hair with a really cool swoop on her forehead. I tucked this under this bubble to kind of add more of a flare to it. You can shape it by pinching it. You can even do little shots where you want it to stick out a little bit more. You can just futz with that all day. Now, sometimes it might create a gap that you really don't like right there. Some people feel weird about this. Some people don't like it. But then it fills in the gap. One thing about being CBA certified, that means I'm a certified balloon artist, is you're taught how to hide the mechanics, hide how things are put together, so people don't realize how you did it. It's like a magician. So I like to take just a little bubble. It's barely bigger than a finger's width. And I tie a knot. This makes a pinch twist. See how it's like a oval shape? It's elliptical, not quite circular. And I take this little piece and I put it at the neck. I grab each side of the tie and I pull it back here. So that's her neck. And it hides all of those other unsightly twists. You could wrap around and twist around the neck area, but in this case, I am just doing a regular tying. Just like we did with the fill in the gaps under the skirt, I just did some knots. Now, if you're going to use scissors to cut, you might want to use round-ended scissors. I'm living dangerously, and I'm using sharp sewing scissors. Got to be careful that those sharp ends don't touch anything else. There we go. Our princess is done and ready for artwork. This lady had light blue eyes. So I'm going to draw big eyes. Now, eyes have shine in them where the light reflects into them. I'm going to do a big shine on that side, and I'm going to do two smaller shines on this side. I'm going to fill in on the sides and a little around the top of our big shine. This is her blue eyes. No, I'm going to get black. And I'm going to fill in her iris. Now, the light doesn't just shine in the black part of your eye. Light kind of goes over both the pupil and the color of the eye. So that's what I've done by putting the shine of the eye where I did and where I placed the color is I have the shine going off of both the iris and the colored part of the eye. And I'm going to go around this one. Big eyes make things look cute. Now she's smiling. She's always smiling and laughing. So I'm going to do a slight curve. The line's not straight. It has just a slight curve so you can tell where her cheek is. I'm going to just a little tiny dot to show the center of her eye. And I'm going to do a nice arch over. And now I'm going to do her eyelashes. I like to do a large one. And then two more smaller going down. And the other side. If you do thick and heavy eyelashes and mascara look, then your doll would look more adult. But keep the top of her eye thin and not so heavy. And it keeps that innocent girl look. She has a nose that points down. So I do a little U followed by two tinier U's for her nose. I do a little comma mark where the top of her smile is. I start to go down. I lift it just the tiniest, go down. She looks like she has a secret. She looks like she's about to laugh. And I'm going to finish the bottom of her lip. That's her smile. Now her eyebrows. There are people, blonde people, with very, very dark eyebrows, but there are some people with very light colored eyebrows. I will show you how I'm going to do the light eyebrows. First, I get a scrap of blush balloon, a little bit of air, I tie it. Now, yellow is too yellow, so I need to blend the color. So what I'm creating is a marker palette. I draw a solid line, and then I draw some dashed lines. You will need a scrap piece of paper, because you're going to have to clean off your marker if it gets too dark. Okay, so I'm going to marker. That's just the yellow. I'm going to marker across the black, and you can see it's darkened to brown. And then when I draw here on the side, it's tart brown. and then gets lighter as the brown works away. And I basically pick up until I have the blonde that I want. Once I have the right mixture of brown and blonde, I can then draw her eyelashes too light, going back, picking up a little bit of the black. Sharpie will blend itself, so you can keep going back and forth until it's all blended the way you want it. And before you put your marker away, very important, before you put your marker away, take your sheet of paper and roll the marker on the paper. So you can see that I'm getting brown as I roll my marker. Just scribble, roll it around until it is yellow again. Then you can cap your marker and put it away to next time. Then I get a Sharpie paint marker. You have to activate it. You have to shake up the paint. It's good to have a piece of colored paper or lined paper, so when you test your marker, you can see if the paint is coming out and working. If it covers up the picture or the colored paper or covered line. Now, the parts that get white, the shine of her eyes. Now you're going to be going really close to the white. The white's going to touch the blue and black. So from time to time, you want to go and wipe the tip of your white marker on the paper to clear it. And then you can keep drawing. No two drawings are ever the same. Clearing my marker. But if you're going to make a lot of these, or if you're not good at drawing, Lisa Patterson, she has come up with a great product called Bada Boom Stickers. And she has all kinds of stickers with the face, the entire face on it. So you could make your balloon and then lay the sticker on the face. And that way each of your balloons will have the same consistent face. Also, if you need to do 10 of these by getting Bada Boom stickers, they are then all, they're all the same face. Looks really nice. I don't like to use stickers because I like to draw, but I do keep in mind that if ever I get a huge order for like maybe 100 of these pretty dolls, I'm going to call Liza Patterson up and I'm going to order some Bada Boom stickers from her. I'm going to put just the little hint. You don't have to draw a lot. I'm just drawing a little bit of a pink lip on the top and a little bit on the bottom. And now I forgot to put in her teeth. So here it is. This is a balloon character of a birthday girl. I won't say how old she is. Thank you for your patience going waiting through all of these video parts with me. I'm going to turn her around so you can see her all the way around. You don't have to put her on a flower base unless you're putting on her a candy cup. I think I started off by doing the candy cup and built her up from the candy cup. And this time I just built the doll. And now I'm going to take my candy cup, grab that knot, push it to the middle of the flower, go up and then down and then go around. And now she is attached to the candy cup. Here she is sideways. Here she is upside down. Now, to finish her off, you can go on to the hummingbird This particular balloon request wanted me to do her friend in balloons holding a flower with a hummingbird. So check out the next hummingbird tutorial that I have, and you'll see how I can finish this doll off in a very, very cute way. Nuts. Remember we said we want to hide the mechanics? There's a nozzle from where I started this balloon. Make sure that that knot is firmly tied and cut the nozzle off. So that way, this hand is nice and finished with just the knot. And this hand's finished at the thumb with just a knot. So you don't see any nozzle, so you can't see where I began or where I ended. And I see she got twisted around again. Give the white of her skirt to the front. Two pinch twists are in the front. One pinch twist is in the back. That's how I designed her. If she's leaning too far back, you can take these two side pinch twists, slide them back and tilt her forward. She can be positioned. So now you can see she's kind of leaning forward in her pretty dress. You can see the pinch twists. You know what? Maybe we should. Yes, let's play. I'm waiting to see if I can add wings to her. Let's see, I see my 260s. Do I have my 160 clear? Or is that the one balloon I keep forgetting to restock in my bag? Let's see, part in a moment. Oh, there it is. 160 clear. I want 160 because they are dainty. Okay. I inflated it, leaving a four-finger tail. Let a little Hesse air out, because when you let the air out, it makes for a soft balloon, and I want this to be soft. I'm told that this is what tree sap balloons would look like if they did not have any color. They'd be kind of a milky clear color. All right, so I look and see where I want the wings. How big do I want the wings? Pardon me. I've been doing a lot of talking. I need to drink more water, get hydrated. So I'm looking at the twist and looking at it and asking, do I want to have one set of wings or two set of wings? You know what? Let's get fancy. Let's do two sets of wings. So two wings are going to be the short wings. I'm folding them and trying to get them roughly the same size. You make a balloon shape, and then you hold it to the figure. Like, I was imagining these going down, but they're not pointing down. So what if I put the pinch twist in the front? Putting it in the front causes them to close together. What if I do a second pinch twist? One pinch twist on either side. That looks really, really fun. All right, I'm gonna get another 160 balloon. I'm wondering, this was made with 160, so if I did two loops, they'd only be the tiniest bit bigger, but what if I wanted them huge? I think I want them huge. So I'm gonna take this and another, I'm gonna take two. Inflate them and tie them together. Yes, what madness are we up to? Sometimes the balloon will start inflating from the middle or from the end. In order to solve that, pinch. See, I'm going to pinch where I want the tail to stop, and then I can keep inflating. But I want these nearly all the way full. Three finger tail, four finger tail. Hiss the air out. Make it soft, make it flexible. Working with clear always scares me. I feel like it's going to pop. Now the reason why I'm a good balloon twister is good balloon twisters don't like balloons popping either, kids. We control when the balloon does pop. Let the air out. They're both nice and soft. And that's how you get to be good balloon twisters. You don't want to pop the balloon, and eventually your fingers will tell you before your eyes do if your balloon's going to pop. Now, I want a spacer bubble, because if these balloons connected to here and I did two big wings, they might not sit exactly where I want them to sit. So I'm gonna do a pinch twist in each side of this balloon. If I made these balloons too soft and I try to do a pinch twist, the pinch twist is not gonna stick. So if you're trying to do a pinch twist and it's not sticking, you made your balloon too soft. There is such a thing as too soft of a balloon. Soft balloons don't pop, but soft balloons don't hold their twists either. Balloons are just big rubber bands. Okay. Now, this is an idea I got. I'm inventing on the fly. Got these nice big wings. And I have these short wings. Now, the question is, how long do I want them? I think this is too big. And again, I'm, for proportion, comparing it. If I put it to the back of my doll, how much higher would they stick up? I'm liking that a lot. So I'm going to pinch. I'm grabbing the whole mass right here, and I'm just twisting them all together. Now, they're just twisted around, which means they can be untwisted. I don't want them to untwist at all. So I'm going to take one loop. I'm going to pull it through the other loop. And where it's sticky, I'm pulling them apart and helping them walk past each other. Okay. So here we go. Two big wings, two little wings. I'm going to shake the big wings. Pull them up. I grab a good handful of the tip and push down like this. So I'm holding up, and where I want the wings to flare out, that's where I don't touch. So when I let go, it goes from being round to this leafy shape. All right, so here we go again. Go up a little bit, grab the end, close the end, and bounce it a few times. Movement creates friction, friction creates heat, heat pops the balloon, so you don't want to do this for too long. And let go, just enough to give that shape. Now these are the back wings, these are the side wings. Now I'm just deciding, do I need to do anything else with these two balloons before I pop them? One, I can just cut and use that to attach to the back of my princess. But I'm asking myself, does it need one more pinch? One more pinch would spread the wings out sideways. That kind of looks enchanting. Okay, one more pinch twist. So, one on either side and one in the back. Now, I'm doing a technique. It's hard to do a pinch push right there. So what I did is I did a bubble, and then I started walking the balloon around that joint, and my bubble automatically is pinched by the tightness of the squeeze. So that's how to do a pinch twist in a very tight and narrow area. Two bubbles on the side, one in the back. So there are some fairy wings. I'm now going to cut this tip off, leaving a string. I'm going to now take my doll. I'm going to pull the string towards the neck. I'm just going around the neck, around the twist, and back to the wings, where I'm going to go around one joint of the wings. I'm going to pull it and let it go. Tuck and adjust. If I was doing this of a little girl, you know how you buy those little girls their fairy wings for their birthday? Just playing around and adjusting the bubbles. There, isn't that enchanting? This one side's just a little too high. It's just a matter of playing and adjusting. Now, if I wanted to, I could get another scrap of clear and maybe attach it here at the waist. So it's attached in two places. But it's kind of fun with that free-floating look. So there we go. We've gone from candy cup to birthday princess to princess fairy. Thank you for staying tuned. Have fun. Do comment on my video. It's the comments that stand out to YouTube more than just clicking like. And it's bonus if you share my video. Even if you don't balloon twist, you might have fun watching me. I'm Madam Eileen Balloon Creations, wishing you a good night. Bye.